You're watching Halborn Flash videos. Our today's guest is Dan Finance, and we have Noah joining in. So Noah, first of all, welcome to our Flash videos. Thanks for joining in. Tell us a little bit about yourself. What's your story?
I watched the original run to $1,000 for Bitcoin, right? And then the back down to 100 and the corresponding Mt. Gox explosion.
Right.
And, you know, that kind of scared me away from crypto for a while. I was young. But then in about 2016, right before the next bull run, my college roommate actually got me back into crypto. And at Boston College, which is where I went to school, we started the first Boston College cryptocurrency club. Mm-hmm. You know, and then followed that bull run. But by the time I had graduated, we were in the middle of crypto winter. So what that meant was, instead of getting right into crypto full time, I went to Fidelity instead, and worked with investment managers to create an asset management software for high net worth clients. Right. Worked there for a few years, and then during the most recent crypto bull run, I decided that was finally time. The siren song had called long enough, and I would get into crypto. And that's when we started DAM about a year and a half ago.
Fascinating. That I quite resonate with a lot of the aspects of the crypto winters and everything else. It's quite a journey thus far. All right. So tell us a bit about DAM Finance. What are you building?
Yeah. So DAM Finance is an omnichain liquidity layer to push liquidity wherever it's most needed using D2O and the dreservoir. What that means is that we want to allow users to kind of move away from centralized exchanges. We want them to have more freedom. And we thought, you know, what's the best way to do that? Stablecoins, probably. They're one of the most used things in crypto, obviously. But we wanted to make them better, right? So we said, what can we do? How can we do that? Well, decentralize them and make them multi-chain. So obviously, we can't go everywhere immediately. But what that means is we're starting with Ethereum and Polkadot and its parachains, most notably Moonbeam right away, with the eventual goal of expanding quite a bit further.
You decided to deploy on Moonbeam and went with the Doxama ecosystem. Any reason behind that or were your choices around it?
Yeah, I mean, we just thought it was growing really quickly. What we actually decided right away was that we loved Moonbeam because of its growth. The EVM compatibility made it easy for us to deploy. It was like a great way to get into the Polkadot ecosystem, right? And now, we basically just want to keep going along that train.
How would you say teleportation is different from wrapping assets? That's the one terminology I came across quite a lot while going through some of the articles you have on your channels.
The difference is mostly in how the actual bridging is done, right? With a classical bridge, you're kind of locking up assets. You're wrapping them on one chain, on the origin chain, and then on the destination chain. You are just using the wrapped representation. And what that means is you're using an asset that has a whole bunch of risk with 0% reward. The reward is obviously you can move around a little bit on the destination chain, but we don't view that as worth the risk of potentially losing all of your money at any instance from hackers, obviously. So the way that we combat that is to, instead of wrap assets, we create D2O natively on every chain that we go to, which means we burn it actually on the origin chain, and then we mint it on the destination chain. Yeah, and we're starting with USDC and USDT to immediately mint, and eventually maybe during the next a little bit more favorable environment, we'll be rolling out lending. So that you can use, you know, any sort of altcoin or anything like that to mint D2O as well.
Wow, that sounds different and quite promising, the way you have approached it. All right, we're talking about Halborn and DAM Finance. So I have to ask you, how did you approach security to begin with? And what were the strategies that you put in place for ensuring that?
Our team is kind of enterprise risk management, you know, with the innovation of crypto. It's kind of where we like to be. We like to be right in the middle where we are, you know, safe with all the code we build, but we also have the crazy innovation side as well, right? and we disliked wrapped assets, so we knew that was straight out. So we actually, you know, decided that we would build, you know, every contract, every smart contract and everything, like the most secure way possible. That means even if it takes slightly more gas, that we can have just an extra check that would make sure that we won't get hacked through any sort of attack on the actual smart contract. We made sure that we couldn't, you know, it wouldn't be possible. That also meant that we needed something called the D2O Guardian because right. of our teleportation layers, actually. We used two of them, Hyperlane and Layer Zero. And we didn't want to trust that they would necessarily deliver every message 100% perfectly. I mean, mm-hmm. obviously, that's what you hope for, right?
Yeah.
But you don't want to rely on it 100% of the time. So we built the D2O Guardian. What that allows us to do is monitor every single transaction on every network and make sure that they're all legitimate. Obviously, we went with Halborn because of your guys' reputation. You guys obviously get the job done, and that's what we needed.
That's always great to hear. When you look at the industry and the space that you're building in, is there anything that you would like to advise them, maybe from a security perspective or just from a building perspective, to the rest of the builders in the community?
Yeah, for sure. I think probably the answer is just take your time, right? It's always better to push out a well-developed product that you've put, you know, your mind through and actually gone through everything, checked it out 100% before putting it out there. You don't want to be the project that gets hacked and then is dead. That's a whole, yeah. It's much more preferable to wait a couple months more to get code out there that you know is completely secure.
Definitely. And we'll be looking forward to it, Sudhir. Thank you. This was a great talk, and it was really enlightening for me to learn a little bit more about DeFi finance. So thanks again for joining us, Noah.